The Elantra nameplate used to be a weakness for Hyundai, but now it's a strength and it's expanding. You not only have the Elantra sedan, which we love, you also have the Elantra GT 5-door, and now the Elantra Coupe. You know, coupes are a great way to express yourself. When you don't have a lot of money, you can do it for around $20,000 in a very stylish way. And you have to admit, this is one of the most stylish coupes on the market today. So we'll start from the back. You have this integrated rear spoiler that really adds a lot of athletic touch to the car. Over here, you have these unique 17-inch wheels, which you don't find on the sedan or the GT. You've got this sculpture design that Hyundai's kind of been integrating into many of their vehicles. And you have a very bold grille, again, unique to the coupe. Most of the vehicles in this segment, which are really highlighted by the Honda Civic Coupe, have a rather lackluster engine. We're talking about here a 1.8 liter inline four, dual overhead cam, 16 valve, producing 148 horsepower, 131 pound-feet of torque. Those aren't great numbers. This car is not gonna, break your neck when you're accelerating 0 to 60, but it's all about fuel efficiency. You can expect to average about 35 miles to the gallon, depending on how you drive and depending if you get the 6-speed manual or the optional 6-speed automatic. Hyundai has really simplified their product offering with the Elantra Coupe. For example, there are only two trim levels. You have a GS or an SE. The GS is the base, SE is the upgraded model, and with the SE, you can get a technology package which adds navigation. Starting price for a base manual GS is around $18,000, and this vehicle could top out at around $24,000 for a fully loaded SE with technology package. As with most coupes, the Elantra Coupe does not offer much in the way of a back seat. I'm not even gonna attempt to get back here. All I can tell you is you do have a back seat. There are seat belts back there. If you have to get some really small people in for a short amount of time, it's okay, but don't buy this car if you're buying it for the back seat. Buy it for its styling, buy it for its great front seat and all the content that Hyundai gives you. Hyundai's got some great gas direct injection or GDI engines in their arsenal. Unfortunately, this isn't one of them. This engine is a little bit lackluster, not exactly suitable, I think, for the sporty styling of the coupe. Nevertheless, it is all about fuel economy, fuel efficiency, and it does that quite well. As far as the interior, I mean, it's really second to none. I think Hyundai's done a tremendous job having so much content, from their Blue Link to their 7-inch navigation screen to all the controls. Everything is really upscale. So there you have it, the Hyundai Elantra Coupe. I think they've made a very bold statement here and presented a real challenge for the big 800-pound gorilla in the segment, the Honda Civic Coupe. I think the styling is better. I like the sculpted body panels. I think the engine is really strong, and they have a lot more content for the money than the Civic. Also great fuel economy. So if you want to go with the tried and true, maybe get the Civic. But if you want to take a chance on something a little bit different, a little more stylish, and in my opinion, just an overall better value, you may want to look at the Elantra Coupe.